Did you just, you came up from Nashville all the way in one?
Yes, 25 hours.
Now see, this is interesting because everybody thinks, oh, it's so glamorous what you do. I would love to do what
you
do.
Oh, it's not glamorous, honey, let me tell you. People think it's so glamorous because all they see is award shows and limos and what's on TV and all the after party stuff and champagne and roses. And it's not, you know, most of the time it's a lot of diesel fumes and quick stops and, you know, where's the toilet paper? And, you know, it's very much like camping in a very expensive Winnebago.
It's a curious life, though, because you're on stage an hour, 2 hours a day, and I'm sure that time is magic.
Yeah, that's great. It is magic.
And
it's the
other
part.
22 is?
Sucks. It really does. The other 22 is, there's a lot of hurry up and then wait.
is the story true, or was it made up by some publicist that when you were a kid, your mom took the knobs off the TV so that you couldn't watch Barbara Mandrell?
Yeah, it was... That's about all they could do that would really affect me in a negative way because I was so crazy about that show. And I loved the show so much that to punish me, they didn't ground me. They just wouldn't let me watch the show. And one night they went out and I was babysitting my little brother and I wasn't supposed to watch the show. So my stepfather took the knob off the television so I couldn't turn it on. So I found some pliers and I turned the television on and he came home and he felt the back of the TV because it was, you know, it was an old fashioned TV and he could tell that I'd been watching it. So I was in serious hell for that.
So no more Barbara Mandrell for
not
at least
for
a few
while,
weeks.
Yeah, for a while.
When did you know that you really had a shot at staying in country music, that you had cleared the hurdle and that you weren't going to be falling back to civilian life?
I'm not really sure if I ever have felt that way. You know, I think it's that hunger and that little sense of competitive nature that I have, you know, that keeps me wanting to keep doing what I do. And I have... I have maintained and earned a fan base over the past 12 years that have been just so loyal and true to me and stayed by my side. And I've had a very up and down career. It's been like a roller coaster, you know. I'll have a hit and then I won't have one for 3 years and then I'll have another one but even with all the ups and downs, I've got a whole show full of hit songs that people recognize now, and it's taken 12 years to get to that point, but I just love to play, and as long as I walk out there every night and I see people there to hear me play, I feel secure in what I do. But when that night comes and I walk out there, I'm like, you can hear a pin drop out there, it might be time for me to hang up my hat.
I love the description that you had when you had a little shift in musical direction recently, and you said you wanted your music to have more horsepower.
Yeah. Well, my personality has a lot of horsepower, so I figured... and I've always cut songs that have a little sarcasm and a little more tempo and attitude and a little more aggressive, I guess, with a traditional twist. When we get cleaned up on Sunday, feel my skin against a string of pearls. But when we hang out, it's just a fun day. You know I love it when I get to be a dirty girl.
If you had to pay your own hard-earned cash to get the tickets to go see some of the greats of country music, who'd be worth the money? Who would you
dead
pay
or
to
alive
see?
Or both?
Both.
Oh, Patsy Cline, definitely. You know, and then there are just the legends of country music. And I've been fortunate enough to have seen just about everybody. Dolly Parton, I've never seen her show. You know, that would be a great one to see. I would have loved to have seen Janis Joplin because of the energy she had on stage, you know.
You're here at the Maine Lobster Festival. Mm-hmm. Have you performed in Maine before?
I've done this festival. Mm-hmm. About 8 years ago I did this festival. And I remember really liking the crowd and thinking they were really energetic and how I would love to do it again. So. We're glad to be back.
Well, singers go around in the summertime and perform at all kinds of interesting festivals. There are garlic festivals and catfish
and
festivals.
And strawberry festivals and mullet festivals. And yes, we've done them all.
So what is the, are there any that were particularly peculiar that made you say, I can't believe that they have a festival organized around
this? Oh, yeah.
This?
Like the mullet festival was pretty bizarre.
Is that the mullet hairdo or the mullet
That's
fish?
That's what we were wondering all the way there. And it was the mullet fish. I didn't know there was a mullet fish. So I thought we were going to see all these, you know, bad Billy Ray Cyrus dudes all over the place. Not that that's bad.
Kind of a letdown when the audience wasn't full of
those mullets.
I was reading an article just within the last week, some musician who was talking about how fans always think that when the musicians are performing, they are totally intent, totally focused on what they're doing. And the guy said, no, that's not the case. Sometimes the mind wanders. Mm-hmm. Now, you are the star, so you're at the center of attention. Are you pretty focused when you're on stage, or does your mind sometimes wander?
I'm really pretty focused. Like, that's my, you know, I really, really can truly say, very seldom does my mind wander, and it's usually during one song in particular where I'm sitting on a stool, and it's this love song, and I'll start thinking about laundry I've got to do. It's piled up and stuff like that. But the rest of the time, like, I really like to connect with an audience, and it's all about that connection, and that's what they're for. They are there for, and that's what I'm here for, and so I can't really connect with them if I'm not connecting. So it's important for me to stay focused and present in that moment.